Hi, this is Wiley Sharp with Denison Yachting, and I'm back up in Annapolis, Maryland right now. Anyways, I was down in Antigua earlier this month with my wife for the Charter Yacht Show, and while I was down there, I got to do a bunch of video walkthroughs. Really excited. I got to do a video walkthrough on the Lagoon 77 for the first time, so I was on board Joy, hull number 4. This boat is not for sale, but she is available for charter and will be heading to French Polynesia. Let's go ahead and jump aboard, take a look. If you've got any questions on the boat, there's going to be a link to the charter page in the description down below. And if you'd like to charter, definitely be sure to reach out to Laura.
On the port sugar scoop, you'll see it's a nice and wide entryway into the water. Hydraulic swim platform, that's about a 16-foot tender with 100 horsepower Honda outboard. I really like the light Sika Flex, or whatever you want to call it, they use on the teak. It keeps it from getting too hot. Through here, we have our first of two mechanical spaces. This boat's powered with Volvos. It's got Onan generators and a really nice mechanical space. Do a quick pano of the salon, but we're going to head around to the foredeck first. Nice wide weather decks. I mean, the first time I went on the Lagoon 77, I was just blown away by the dimensions. I mean, this is by far the biggest boat that Lagoon has ever built, or the largest catamaran I think that's ever been built at CNB. I like how they have the tow rail. It's kind of a molded high tow rail with accent lighting throughout. I think that's a nice feature that a couple of other manufacturers have also started incorporating as well. Nice split trampoline with a bowsprit with a furler. I'm sorry, a code zero. Obviously, it's on a furl, it's furled up. And then a hydraulic Genoa and a hydraulic staysail. I think I mentioned it's a split trampoline. We got crew cabins here through both four peaks. Tons of storage in the these deck lockers here, as well as the anchor locker. We got our forward cockpit here. I'll do kind of a quick pano of that. You can enter it either through the steps there or through the salon. I like the sunshade that they added to the boat. It's a nice touch. So I'll do a quick pano kind of facing aft. We're going to make our way down the starboard weather deck. Another opportunity to see like just how wide it is. And look how tall this coach roof is. I mean, this is just a big freaking catamaran. All the hatches are flush mounted hatches. Once again, we can see the tender and hydraulic swim platform. So we've got dining for comfortably six over here on the starboard settee, sun pad up top. Nice bench seat aft, and then a settee and sun pad over to port. Do a quick pano through here of the cockpit. Lots of storage in these deck lockers here as well too. Through this door, we've got access to the galley, but I'll show you that when we go down below. Make our way up to the flybridge, which is arguably the most impressive part of this yacht. So we've got this huge, huge daybed aft. We've got these tables that actually fold out where you could easily fit 10 up here for dining. We've got a wet bar with a Kenyan grill. Twin helms. Great visibility from the helm as well too. And then all the winches, which are obviously on a boat this size, they're all going to be powered winches. Everything leads right back here to the helm. That was actually one of the things when I first got on one of these Lagoon 77s that impressed me the most, was how good the visibility was from the helm. I mean, you can see here, you can see both bows. And then if you're coming into starboard side, you can see your starboard sugar scoop. Or if you're coming in port side too, you can use the port helm and see your port side sugar scoop, making it a pretty easy boat to handle. Let's go ahead and head back down to the cockpit and then take a look inside. Making our way here in the salon on Joy, Lagoon 77, off by about 20 feet there. So over on the port side, we've got the main dining table or interior dining space. You could comfortably sit 10 at that table. We've got a wine cooler, center line. We've got the dry bar there. Port forward, we have the nav station, but it's equipped with all BNG electronics. Really good visibility from the nav. And I love this kind of settee up here, center line forward. So if you're underway and you do want to stay in the air conditioning, you can still kind of be part of the action and get a break from the elements. Over on the starboard side, we've got a nice U-shaped settee. Just this whole boat, it's so large, but it's still a very comfortable, cozy, kind of homey feeling boat. I think the owners did a really, really nice job appointing her. And yeah, I mean, it's just a really, really well done boat. So if you're the owners and you built it, good job, guys, if you watch this video. I mean, you already know that. You don't need my validation. Starboard aft, we've got one of the VIP staterooms. It's a walk-around queen-size berth. Nice large window on the outboard side. Nice vanity over here on the starboard or the outboard side with shelving. Plenty of storage on this boat. I mean, you've got hanging lockers everywhere on the boat. Forward, we've got the head, so single basin sink, mirror. On the outboard side, a rain shower as well as a wand shower. And then on the inboard side, we've got the actual Tecma freshwater head in its own separate place with storage as well too. I mean, I think that's the biggest thing. When you get into a catamaran in this size range, it really becomes all about the storage. Now we're gonna shoot across to the port side. I'm gonna show you the galley, crew cabin, and second VIP. I wanna save the master stateroom for last because it's really something else. So coming down the port companionway, we're gonna head aft, and we've got a bunk room here, which can either be used for guests or as a crew cabin. Got a the head, sink, vanity, toilet, you know, all the good stuff. Outboard side, got a nice desk. And then making our way aft, we've got the galley, as well as, I guess you would call it the crew lounge, which is really unique in a boat in this size range to have such a nice, not just galley down, but a crew area. I mean, this boat will always have a crew on it. I can never imagine an owner operator on a catamaran this size. There's just too much to take care of for most people that'll own a boat like this. So having this really nice crew space is gonna really keep your crew happy, and a happy crew means a, you know, happy boat. Moving port forward, we've got the second VIP stateroom, which is an athwartship king size berth, all full walk around. I love how the window is just right there at the foot of the bed. Vanity over here on the outboard side. And then we've got the head port forward. It's got a single basin sink, vanity and mirror, plenty of storage, a very large shower with a rain shower, as well as the wand. And then on the inboard side, just after the shower, we have the actual head for this port forward stateroom. We're going to pop across the salon, take a look at the master, not without first doing a quick pano though. I love how much those doors pocket for the companionway or the entry into the salon. It just creates a really nice flow. So here we've got that kind of day lounge or whatever you want to call it that I was mentioning when we were looking at the chart station. And then we've also got a door to the forward cockpit here. Going down starboard forward, we get to the master stateroom, which honestly, I think it's really tough for me to decide which master stateroom I like more, the Sunreef 80 or the Lagoon 77. They're both really nice staterooms. So we've got an athwartship full walk-around king-size berth, tons of natural light. One thing that my wife absolutely loved about this boat was the walk-in closet. I mean, just look at this thing. Quick pano in the master. So aft, we've got a nice settee on the outboard side. On the inboard side, we've got a desk. And then aft, we've got the master head, dual basin sink, vanity, and mirror. We've got a really, really nice shower. and it's right at the window there. So, I mean, I can't even imagine how cool that must be, taking a shower there. And then over on the inboard side, we've got the actual head. So this is the Lagoon 77 Joy. She's available for charter. So if you've got any interest in that, please be sure to contact Laura Jagielski. And if you have any questions on this boat, please leave a comment down below. Shoot me an email. And as always, if you like what I have to say, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks and have a good day.